Okay, and now I am installing the pack. I have in here this tool. And I check all time that this part moves. A little bit more. This part must be in together. Okay. Longer. Okay, good. Now these parts. This part is tight. Excellent. And then I take my bearing. And bearing is here. Bearing. Excellent. And now I believe that these parts are well. Excellent. And now new bearing is in back. Thanks. Okay, and then I need to measure that this amount is same as it was in the starting point when I had this old bearing in here. And I take my measurement tool and then I measure this amount, and it should be something like, it was something like 24 or 22. Okay, this is quite nice amount. I believe that this should be enough, because if this is too much or too less, then we have difficulties to install these parts. And now I check that. Now I test that. Is this enough to cool? Okay. I think that maybe I need to little bit hammer that down, that part. They are in same plane. Okay. Now I think that these parts are well. Okay, and then I need to install this cover back. And I need to install glue in here. And first we need to clean that area. And this cover also totally clean. And then I start to install is my glue in there carefully in here inside in here. and I inserted my glue in here. And this is this gasket glue, this red one. And I installed this glue in here, and then I insert this my cover back, and it's my next job. Okay, and now I have installed glue in that side and also this cover side. And next part is that I need to install this cover back in there. Let's look at how it happens. Here is this my part, and in that way I install good. Okay, and now this bearing is in, this cover is in there, and next I need to install in here those bolts, those cover bolts, and I will add those next. And there's my cover bolts in there. Okay, and now when I am installing these cover bolts back, now there's a situation that I need to install in here this soft lock. This is like locking this glue for bolts a little bit, and this color is this blue. That amount in there, and then bolt back in there. And there is so big vibration in this gearbox that's we need that locking glue in this, and this is like soft blue color. And now I install this glue in this bolts, all bolts, and then I fasten this bolts, and then we can continue. Okay, and in that step I install also this spring bolts, look, that kind of things in here, and I lock these bolts using my air gun. Okay, good, and now these parts are excellent, and then I continue my this bolts installation in here. Okay, and then I install this specific bolt in that area, and now we have to be sure that this gearbox parts, they are just in same position, because there must be this hole that I can install this my bolt in there inner, and if this hole is not in right position, I need to take that cover out and install this part again, because this is locking bolt. And now, when this is in position, I can rotate that in inner. And now in this my case, it looks like that this my position is just perfect. I was lucky. This part goes in directly in there. Very nice. And this is like reverse gear locking bolt. Good. Now it's there. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and in that part we have to do this movement test. And movement test means that when I rotate these shafts, both of those, they must be rotated easy way. And also, when we look in this differential, look, these parts must move in their inner area. Okay, and everything looks good. And then, what then if I try to rotate these and nothing, and it seems that gearbox is stuck. Then I need to a little bit lift that up, and maybe this helps to move those parts. But if still, if there is stuck, then I need to disassemble all of these parts away, because gearbox parts must always move freely.